Larry, from one of the truly iconic stadiums in the NFL, there's a look at Lambeau Field here in Green Bay, Wisconsin. Coming up, we've got a good matchup on tap between the Dallas Cowboys and the Green Bay Packers. On the return, this is Micah Hyde. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. First carry now. This is Lacy. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. Now, Lacy left that game against the Giants in ankle injury, but expected to be okay prior to leaving. 11 carries, 81 yards.
And you saw the Eddie Lacy signature spin move a couple of times as well. He is just some type of a back, and I think he's gotten into a good rhythm here in 2016. He didn't get to 100 yards, probably because of the ankle injury. They need him back, and in a big way. His backup, James Starks, struggling in the early going.
5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
Partner, the one concern I had about Eddie Lacy coming out of Alabama was weight. And it became a concern for Green Bay in 2015.
Yeah, he was up over 260 pounds. Disappointing 2015. Looks a lot better, doesn't it?
A lot better. And when he's lean, oh, boy, is he a heck of a runner.
They go play action here on first down. Blitz coming, and down he goes. They dial up the corner blitz that time, and it delivers to the tune of a 9-yard loss.
Oh, my goodness. Was that a defensive back that got to him with the pressure?
Oh, look at the former defensive back. You're all smiles up here.
I hope everybody can hear my smile on that play.
On second down, Lacy. And he'll be tackled just past the 35 at the 36. He was able to pick up 6 yards there, so that leaves him with a third and 13.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
Yeah, they've got an extra defensive back out there now on third and 13. Rodgers now to throw. Surveying the field. And he goes out right around the 39. Give him 3 on the play, and that's going to make it 4th down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. Now the second-year man from Buffalo, Jake Shum, on to punt. Lucky Whitehead back deep for Dallas. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1-yard line. These Dallas Cowboys on offense, they have been humming. In fact, you and I were discussing before the game, first team in NFL history to have a rookie QB with 1,000 yards passing and a rookie running back with 500 yards rushing through 5 games.
Those numbers would be good no matter what year they're in the league. But when you say rookie at quarterback, rookie at running back with that, that's off the charts. And boy, that offensive line, they get to walk around big smiles knowing how much they've contributed to that.
And this one caught by Dez Bryant. And they're going to get this one up past the 25. A good pick up there, 26 yards.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
They run with a rookie. Here's Elliott. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. And that right there will set him back a bit on the offensive holding penalty.
And you know who you want to pressure after a penalty like that? The guy who just committed the foul. You want to see if he's going to keep his head down or if he's going to get his head right back into the game. I'd send a blitz at him right away and see if he holds up.
10-yard penalty there on first down. So now first and 20. A give to Elliott. And he'll power his way up near the 25. Charles, Ezekiel Elliott, he's on quite a 3-week stretch, isn't he?
He certainly is. And when you think about where he was drafted, number 4 in the entire draft, and the prevailing wisdom that says you don't draft a running back that high, you can get get him back later on who will do the same type of damage. I don't know if it's going to continue to hold up that way. Ezekiel Elliott is powering the Cowboys in the early season.
134 on the yardage side against the Bengals and two touchdowns. And he was able to shed the tackle, but the reserves come in for the stop. Give him 2 yards that time, and it's going to leave him with a third and 11 situation.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense, and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
Here's Prescott. He's got time. Under pressure, and he'll go down. They'll sack him on what ought to be the final play of this first quarter. So the Cowboys will punt it on fourth down, as on is the veteran Chris Jones to kick it away. Back deep for the Packers, Micah Hyde. On a return, it's Hyde. A good return there, call it 13 yards. Back onto the field, the Green Bay Packers offense comes. That O-line has been good. They parted ways with Josh Sitton. People were wondering, how would they do? They've done pretty well.
Yeah, they don't really get their due. And let's go through them real quick. David Bakhtiari, left tackle. Lane Taylor stepping in for Sitton at guard. J.C. Treader at center. T.J. Lang at right guard. And the right tackle, Brian Bulaga. They understand their quarterback, and they know they have to keep plays alive for him to work his magic.
First down, Rodgers. Toward the right sideline, but it's incomplete. Devontae Adams, the intended receiver. You and I, Charles, have had a lot of talk recently about the success of the Cowboys and Prescott and Zeke Elliott. He could be on pace to break Eric Dickerson's rookie year rushing record.
What was that, 1808?
Yeah.
I mean, that's a big number right there, but he's playing awfully well. And how about a blast from the past? I'm going to give you a name. Remember Mike Anderson?
Mm-hmm.
Denver Broncos? Zeke's the first rookie running back to be, what, over 130 yards in 3 games since Mike Anderson.
This is Cobb with a catch right side. 4 yards on the pickup. A little bit of a breakout game for Cobb in week 5. 9 catches, 108 yards. And Charles, 12 catches through the season's first 3 weeks was all he had.
So you can see how he increased production in the last game against the Giants. The pride of Alcoa, Tennessee, Randall Cobb. And I'm just going to tell you, if I ever dive into fantasy football, I'm getting him on my team because I think he's going to continue to bring those numbers back to the 2014 levels.
Still back there. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. And nobody was open downfield there. Looked like a pretty clear throwaway.
Yeah, definitely was that. I'm wondering why there wasn't intentional grounding. I know they're saying there's a receiver there in the area. Those darn quarterbacks, they get away with everything.
Spoken like a true defensive back, Mr. Davis.
Did that come out?
It did.
Okay.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And this will be taken at the 13. It'll be a 48-yard punt. 5 there on the return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a 1st and 10. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They start on the ground with Elliott. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle. That's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold him to no gain.
They go down once again. And he's brought down. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. So good for the Buckeyes last year, and he's taken that from the college game, showing some glimpses of it here in the NFL.
How about his last season with Ohio State? Over 1,800 yards, only 1 game where he didn't get over 100. Remember, he demanded the ball from then on out. I think they listened to him, and they were smart to do so.
And now they're giving it to him here on the next level. Now Prescott. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that up second down. Let's go league-wide here. The Atlanta Falcons. You know, we haven't talked about them a whole lot up to this point, but back-to-back weeks beating Carolina and Denver, the two teams that played in the Super Bowl.
And I know that many people earlier in the season were saying, well, remember they started 5-0 in 2015 and they collapsed and didn't make the playoffs. But after what you just described, being the two Super Bowl participants back-to-back weeks, including Denver on the road, I think people believe this team's for real.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
It looks like the Packers have added an extra DB on third down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw to the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
I know they don't like to hear it when they get to a certain age, but then you have to start to use your skills, your wiles, right, your mind to beat guys to the football, and getting your toes tapped inbounds definitely qualifies as that, doesn't it?
The veteran showing he still has the agility. And that hits at the six and carries into the end zone for a touchback. Now the Packers get set to go. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the three and out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go, because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it up. They start the drive on the ground with Lacy. And a decent gain there as that takes us to the two-minute warning. Rodgers, wide open receiver complete, 15 yards through the air and a first down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Throwing on first down is Rodgers. He completes it to Jordan Nelson. 22 yards of the pickup there, and it'll be a Green Bay first down.
And another thing that makes a comeback route really effective is that oftentimes after you've made the initial move, receiver's breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. A nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
319!
Rodgers now on first down. He's got time in the pocket, and his throw here's incomplete. Good job by the O-line. Quarterback had time to go through his checks. That's one you need to take advantage of.
A perfect situation, and they're unable to take advantage of it. When you have that much time to scan the field, you have to find an open receiver.
Rodgers will try again on second down. In the middle of the field, he's got Nelson. And he's brought down. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it. Now the confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Now Rodgers. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone. Rodgers Rodgers to throw once more. And complete right side to Cook. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Again, they'll throw with Rodgers. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
So on now for the Packers at their all-time leading scorer, Mason Crosby. From the right hash, this from 33. And Crosby puts it through, and the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. So after slogging through a scoreless first quarter, we have action on the scoreboard. A field goal makes it 3-0.
Well, with these two offenses, we weren't going to stay 0-0 forever, were we? I'm not sure that this opens the floodgates, but I doubt that's the last scoring we're going to see.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. This is taken at the three. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complementary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. Took the words right out of my mouth. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Six yards to go here on second down. Now Prescott. A dump off to Elliott. And he's brought down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. Here's Prescott. Finding time. He hits Beasley right side. A gain of four on the play, and that'll make it a second down. And quickly, they get to the line. Now flags fly in, and one of the Cowboys looked like he got going a little early. So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down. Back to throw again. Bryant with a catch right side. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it third and one. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So on third down, the field goal unit will come out as he'll try to get three before half. This from 54 yards away. And this one is no good. He missed it. And this score will stay right where it is.
And this is one of the risks you run when you attempt a long field goal. If you miss, the defense takes over the spot of the placement. So now they've got a chance to get one more drive in before halftime.
And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. One receiver left, three to the right. The final shot before half for Rodgers. And his throw's going to be incomplete. So we've hit halftime, just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we'll send you down to Orlando as we check in with Larry Ridley and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry, now it's Lucky Whitehead on the return. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Out come the Cowboys now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Second half starts with a carry by Elliott. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
That was a really nice play, being able to stack that one up. When they get back in the huddle, he's got to tell his guys up front, great job. They kept people off of him, allowed him to run free, and make the hit on the runner.
Filled the gap nicely, kept him to just a one-yard gain. Bryant, the lone receiver, left. Looking to throw. And this one complete to Witten over the middle. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He had told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up in the top shelf.
And it's a fumble, and the Packers pick it up. And his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They come out here in the eye.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield. First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Second and very short here, less than a yard. Now Rodgers throwing on second down. And incomplete. Eddie Lacy, the one he was trying to get it to. And it's third and short. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
One back is Lacy. Rodgers to throw on third and one. And he finds Cook. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
a first down carry. It's Lacy. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
On second down, here's Rodgers. In the middle of the field, he's got Nelson. It's a gain of six on the play, and all of a sudden here, it's third down. Short of the sticks after that completion, and now it's third down for this offense. They come out here in the eye. They'll try and run for it. Here's Lacy. And he will have the first down across the 20 to the 19-yard line. It goes as a gain of eight that moves the chains.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
They'll run here. This is James Starks. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Second down following the run. Now Rodgers will handle Lacy. So oftentimes you see defensive holding. Here it's offensive holding for the flag. That'll go as a loss of nine, and it leads to third down. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Back now at Lambeau. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Following the penalty now, Lacy. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 12 yards is the pickup there, and that's going to bring up a third down. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take. Puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he's going to be taken down right at the line. Nothing doing on that one, and it'll be fourth down. So they go pass on third and two. They complete it, but no gain. Should they have tried to run it?
I thought that running the ball in that situation is what they would have done because at worst-case scenario, you may bring up a fourth down decision for your team. Instead, now, they're not close to the first down.
And Crosby puts it through. And the drive will wind up yielding three. So they get the three here, but you wonder whether that's going to be enough.
Yeah, I mean, you've now made it so they need a touchdown rather than a field goal to catch them. But you're right. If they'd gotten six out of that drive, this would be a much different game.
After the made field goal, now Crosby will do the kickoff duties. Whitehead, the return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The offense for the Cowboys now working their way back onto the field. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though? when they only gave up the field goal, and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive, a little more pep in their step because they didn't cost their team a touchdown. But they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punching the end zone without turning it over.
So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen. But everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they show to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle. There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely. I mean, size, the hands.
The speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
Come on, let's go. One, nine, cut.
Here's Prescott. Surveying the field. Great protection. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
There's a little bit of defense right there. Nickel set, five defensive backs. They just snuffed out every route that was going. Quarterback never got rid of the football.
Come on, let's go. Red 38.
Now Prescott. Completes it to Jason Witten. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. Call it a pickup of 7, and that's going to lead to a third down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
And let's see what the defensive coordinator may have up his sleeve here to try to get this final last stand and win this football game. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And on the left side, he's got Witten. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end. Let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
It's a 5-receiver set. 3 to the left, 2 to the right. They'll look to throw here on first down. He's got time. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. And he had a quick little spin move, but the door shut fast as he's dropped.
I really don't know where to go with this one. He caught the pass, but in the opposite direction towards his own end zone. That's not one you get every game.
And, of course, the quarterback in this situation, he's realizing time is becoming a factor. Let's see if they can get some points on the board here late. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He's got time in the pocket. A hit as he throws there, incomplete. Side here to Bryant, and he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line. It's a gain of 5 on the play, and they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long. They'll look to throw, finding time. He's going to let it fly, and that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. And this is going to be ruled out, I think, just inside the 20. Yes, it will. Side judge calls it
at the 19-yard line. The Packers offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. They have the lead, still a one-possession game, but the defense got the stop. They've got the football now, just salted away, right?
Exactly. That's all the defense is counting on from their offense. They did their job in a big way. You know they're over on the sidelines now, starting to take their tape off. Hey, we've done this thing. The offense has to put it away, and that meet.
And now a timeout called by the Cowboys defense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point,
the kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him at contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe.
Now a 10th carry here for Lacy. And now the Cowboys are going to call another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. An extra defensive back in the game now here for 3rd and 4. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. That'll be their 3rd and final stoppage here as we step aside. Looking to get out of here with a win as they take the knee. Rodgers will take a knee here, and that should be all she wrote. The storyline of this one, Charles, no doubt the number zero, zilch, nada. A shutout so hard to do in the NFL.
It really is, and what an accomplishment, because you feel that not just on the defensive side, but as a full team. There's a lot of pride that goes into shutting out an opponent. And how about that zero on the scoreboard for them, going along with those zeros in the time column, too?